Hello and welcome to another uMake tutorial. My name is Nico and this is the third installment in the How to Create a Combination Lock lesson series that we've been making. In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to add some arrayed elements to the actual lock part and change the materials. Let's jump in and change the materials first and then we'll add some arrayed elements. So the first thing I want to do is I kind of want to give this a more silver sheen, a more shiny sheen here. So I'm going to go in and select the parts that I want to change the colors of. So there's the body. And I'm going to come up here to this little sphere looking element in the top menu once I have these selected. And I'm going to just tap here and I'm just going to scroll down and select silver. So you'll see that once I've selected that, the material looks a little bit more shiny, more kind of silvery. So that looks pretty good. Now let's do that for this part here. So I'll select this surface and I'll come over and select this surface. If you remember, we made this in two parts, but that's okay. And I'll add some, I'll add some chrome to this actually, just to kind of give a little bit of differentiation. The chrome is really shiny looking. And for the last thing, it's this revolved surface. I want to make this a nice blue color. So I'm going to double tap on this. And then I'm going to come up here to the colors, the surface colors. And I'll just choose a color here. Make it a little brighter. And I want more of a royal blue. Something like that. So there is the center of the lock that's been colored. Now to finish this up, let's add some nice arrayed elements. So what I'm going to actually do is I'm going to come back over to the side view and I'm going to draw a small rectangle. There we go. And I'm just going to kind of squish this guy down a little bit, make it pretty small. And what I want to do is I want to just kind of extrude it just a tad bit. So I'm going to actually select the curve and tap extrude. And I'm going to actually tap two ways like this. And I'll just pull out on this yellow handle. And I just need to make it about that big. It doesn't have to be a whole lot. Once I'm done, tap the green check mark and that will create an extruded surface. I'll create a surface here. So select this edge curve here, tap the little surface icon there, do the same thing again, tap this, and then this is the little create surface icon in the middle, tap that, that created a surface. So now we have a rectangular box. It's a little big, but that's okay. We're gonna take care of that. I'm using the lasso tool to select everything. And I'm just gonna move this down and then I'm gonna scale it down even more. And I'll rotate this so that it's about the same angle as the knob. I'll bring this down and just kind of drop it in a little bit like that. So now it's sticking up just a little bit. That's exactly what we want. While it is still selected, I'm going to go to the top view and I am going to tap the array function. So I'll tap array. And actually, before I do this, I'm gonna change its color. So let's try and select that one more time. So it should have selected everything using the lasso tool. And let's actually come up and change its color. I want it to be white. So did that do that? Let's see. Yep, perfect. Make sure everything is selected. Maybe blue is not the best color for the centerpiece because the selection color is blue, but it'll look good in the end. So once I've selected that rectangular, I'm going to tap the array function, go to the top view, and you'll see if I zoom in, there's a little tiny green circle in the middle of this array. And I just want to take that green circle and bring it into the middle here, and it's going to snap because we have these circles. And you'll see that there is currently 5 copies of that little dash mark. I'm going to turn this into 16. So I'm going to come over and tap copies here and just take the slider and move it all the way up to 16. And once I'm done with that, I'll just hit the green check mark. And now we have 16 numbers on this combination lock. And that's pretty much all there is to it. So in just a couple of lessons, we have gone ahead and created the body of the lock, the center knob, and the lock element, changed the materials, and created an arrayed pattern of elements. It's pretty easy. So now you have a complete combination lock. I definitely encourage you to follow these and try and make your own. We would love to see what you create. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback for us, or just want to share your work, feel free to contact us or reach us through our YouTube channel, Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. Really hope this helped you guys, and can't wait to see what you create. Take care and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.